Hello students, welcome to the class. So in the previous class we had started with the questions on amines and biomolecules. So we are going to continue with the further questions. We had finished with around 70 questions. Now here we have the 71st question. The major product of the following reaction is, so they have given the reaction, it is a cyanide compound. Yes, when cyanides are treated with aluminium tertiary butoxide, so isobutoxide, yes. So this is the compound, and further followed by hydrolysis. So what do we get? This will give hydrogen. So what we get is, we get a intermediate compound RCH double bond N, yes. And then on further, this is second step, on further hydrolysis. So I'll write hydrolysis here. On further hydrolysis, I get RCHO. Remember, when we use this reagent followed by hydrolysis, cyanides get converted to aldehydes. So aldehyde is the product which is obtained. So it is option A. Next question, an organic compound C3H9N, it is named as A, when treated with, so there is an organic compound. So they have said there is an organic compound. Let us say there is an organic compound A. This is treated with nitrous acid, HNO2, gave an alcohol. So it gives alcohol here. So it gives an alcohol, and nitrogen gases evolved, plus N2 gases evolved. A, on warming with CHCl3, this on warming with CHCl3 and caustic potash gave a compound C, which on reduction with isopropyl methyl amine, which on reduction gave isopropyl methyl amine. So on reduction, it is giving isopropyl methyl amine. That means it is giving CH3, CH2, CH3. So not CH2, here it is NH2. So this is isopropyl methyl amine. So it is giving product, this product. So what is the compound A, they have said? See, as A gives alcohol on treatment with nitrous acid, it is giving an alcohol, means it should be a primary amine. So they have said C3H9N. So C3H9N has possibly two structures with NH2 group, if you see. For example, we have two structures here. CH3, CH2, CH2, NH2. This is one expected structure. Another one is CH3, CH, NH2, CH3. See, I have to take NH2 only because it should be a primary amine, because only primary amines on treatment with the nitrous acid give alcohols. Only primary amines give alcohols. So as it gives isopropyl methyl amine, it should be isopropyl amine, not N propyl amine. So it is giving isopropyl methyl amine on treatment with CHCl3 and KOH. So it should be isopropyl amine only. So it should be this amine only. If it is normal amine, that is N methyl amine, then it would have given N methyl amine only here. Yes. So it is giving this amine, means, so it should be isopropyl compound only. Yes. So what is the correct option? The correct option is option A. This is the correct option. So you have to understand what product you are getting, and depending on the product, you have to predict the reactant on the depending upon the reagents also. Nitrobenzene on reaction with concentrated nitric acid and sulfuric acid. Concentrated nitric acid. If you want, I'll show you the reaction also for this. Yes, you can note down also. You see, my guess is this, then see here, CH3, CH, NH2, and then CH3 here. With nitrous acid, what will happen? With nitrous acid, it will give CH3, CH, OH, CH3 plus nitrogen gas is evolved. It is giving an alcohol. Warming with the chloroform, CHCl3 and KOH. Warming with chloroform, what do we get? We get CH3, CH, CH3, and this becomes CNC. Isocyanide is formed. Isocyanide on reduction, what it will give? CH3, CH, CH3. NHCH3. Is it not giving isopropyl methyl amine? This is isopropyl methyl amine. So this is isopropyl methyl amine. Correct? So what should be the compound? It should be this amine only. Understanding? You can note down the reaction also. Okay. Fine. Okay. So this is how we are going to solve the questions. If they are asking the product, we'll solve the sequence. If they're asking the reactants, we'll come back in the different form. Okay, nitrobenzene on reaction with concentrated nitric acid and sulfuric acid at 80 to 100 degrees Celsius forms which of the following compounds? Nitrobenzene. So nitrobenzene is NO2. So they have said a mixture of concentrated HNO3 and concentrated sulfuric acid. So it is nitrating mixture at 80 to 100 degrees Celsius. Nitrobenzene when treated with this mixture, this is nitrating mixture which will produce NO2 plus electrophile, and this is the NO2 substituent already attached, and this is meta-directing substituent. So I will get the product. NO2 is already here. This is meta-directing group, so I will get NO2 here. So I will get 1,3-dinitrobenzene. Dinitrobenzene. This is the product what we get. 1,3-dinitrobenzene. Yes. Next question. So you can see here, mixture of concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid gives NO2 plus ion, which act as a nucleophile electrophile. And in nitrobenzene, already NO2 group is there. So it is a meta-directing group. So NO2 plus ion will attack meta position. Yes. Okay. In the reaction, NO2, and here there is Br, and here there is N2 plus Cl. So here there is a diazonium salt. Very, very, very commonly asked question. So let whatever be present at the other sides, students, Br, Cl, anything, but here they have said it is diazonium salt. And they have said the product formed is, this Br is retained as it is, NO2 is retained as it is. Instead of this part, there is hydrogen coming here. That's the reason it is forming a ring here, right? So it is hydrogen here, substituted hydrogen. So what is the reagent A? You will get hydrogen here when you use H3PO2 and H2O. H3PO2 and H2O. So using this reagent only, we will get, it is nothing but the reagent using benzene diazonium chloride, N2 plus Cl minus, when treated with H3PO2 and H2O, H3PO4. And H2O, you will get benzene. Hydrogen gets substituted. So you'll get benzene. So here also, we get hydrogen substituted, and this is the product. So the correct option is option D. It is option D. We have seen all the reactions of benzene diazonium salts. In that, this was one of the reaction. In the reaction, the product A is. So very good question. It is a coupling reaction. So benzene diazonium chloride, we have benzene diazonium chloride, N2 plus Cl minus, and it is treated with aniline. Whenever coupling of diazonium salts occur, the reaction occurs at para position to this amino group. So hydrogen and Cl comes out as HCl in presence of an acid. So what do we get? We get this coupling reaction. CN bond retains as it is. Then we get benzene ring here, and then NH2. Para amino azobenzene. So it is para amino azobenzene, which is yellow in color. Which is yellow in color. Yes. So it is a dye, yellow dye. Yes. So what is the correct option? It is option D. So major product is formed by para attack. Which of the following will be most stable diazonium salt? So which of the following will be most stable diazonium salt? Look there, they have given CH3 and 2 plus X minus methyl diazonium halide, phenyl diazonium halide, ethyl diazonium halide, and benzyl diazonium halide. See, aromatic diazonium salts are more stable because there is a benzene ring and there will be dispersal of positive charge in the benzene ring. Therefore, whenever we look at the stability of diazonium salts, aromatic diazonium salts will be most stable. Now, the question arises, is it B or D? D is not aromatic. You can see there, the nitrogen is not directly attached to the benzene ring. Instead, it is attached to the carbon atom of which is attached to the benzene ring. So, we say that it is attached to the side chain, correct? So, which is the correct option? Correct option is option B. It is a phenyl or benzene diazonium halide. Yes, benzene diazonium halide. Aryl diazonium halides are more stable than alkyl diazonium halides. Next question. The electrolytic reduction of nitrobenzene in a strongly acidic medium. Electrolytic reduction. Yes, you are carrying out reduction by giving, by applying electric arc. So we will call it as electrolytic reduction of nitrobenzene. So electrolytic reduction, and they have said it is a strongly acidic medium. It is strongly acidic medium. Okay. So in strongly acidic medium, what happens? What happens is the reduction means addition, removal of oxygen or addition of hydrogen. You will get NHOH here. This is called phenyl. This is phenyl hydroxyl amine. Phenyl hydroxyl amine. So you'll get phenyl hydroxyl amine. But this being unstable, it will undergo rearrangement. What it will undergo? It will undergo rearrangement because OH group cannot be present on nitrogen. It will undergo rearrangement. Then OH group will attack at, so here we will have NH. This OH will attack at para position. The hydrogen comes out to nitrogen. It will become NH2 and here it will be OH. So what is the name of this compound? Yes, it is para-aminophenol. Because OH is more prioritically, OH comes first. So it will be para-aminophenol. Yes. So what do we get? Yes, it is option D, para-aminophenol. So you should remember this electrolytic reduction. We get NHOH, phenyl hydroxylamine, which is unstable. It will undergo rearrangement to give para-aminophenol. The following reaction, aniline with benzaldehyde, NaOH, gives NH C double bond O, this. So what is this reaction? You can see here, CO, C double bond O group and this benzophenyl group. So this group is getting substituted to hydrogen here. So this reaction is nothing but, it is nothing but benzoylation. Yes, what it is? It is benzoylation because benzoyl group. What is benzoyl group? Benzene ring and C double bond O. Benzoyl group is getting substituted. Or where it is getting substituted? It is getting substituted to aniline. So benzoylation of aniline, this reaction is nothing but benzoylation of aniline, which is an example of Scotton-Baumann reaction. Scotton-Baumann reaction. Example of Scotton-Baumann reaction. So which is the correct option? It is nothing but potassium salt of thalamide treated with chlorobenzene. Yes, a slight mistake is there over this. Yes, the options are printed wrong, students. Sorry for the mistake. Take the options. Option A is acetylation reaction. Option B is Scotton-Baumann reaction. Option C is Friedel-Crafts reaction. And option D is Perkins reaction. So what is, these options are wrong, students. I'm sorry for the inconvenience. These are the options. And what is the correct option? It is benzoylation of aniline and it is an example of Scotton-Baumann reaction. So option B is the correct option. You can mark down the options also. Yes, okay. So moving to the next question. The number of structural isomers possible for molecular formula C3H9 N. So C3H9N, very easy. Go on writing 1, 2, 3 NH2. When you are particular, perfect about the isomers, you need not mention the hydrogens. Yes, this is one way. Structural isomers possible. Structural, they have said. So 1, 2, 3 and NH2 here. This is another way. This is normal amino propane. This is isopropyl amine. Yes, both are primary amines. 1, 2, NH and this. This is secondary amine. This is primary. This is also primary. This is secondary. Or I can write it as this. This is tertiary amine. So altogether, how many are possible? There are four structural isomers possible, which are also these three are the examples of functional isomers also. The correct statement regarding the basicity of aryl amines is, so aryl amines are generally less basic than alkyl amines because the nitrogen lone pair electrons are delocalized. Interaction with aromatic ring pi electron system. Aryl amines are generally more basic than alkyl amines because the nitrogen lone pairs electrons are not delocalized. See, aryl amines, we know that aryl amines are nothing but, let us take example, it is aniline. Yes, let me write it like this. Yes, this is aryl amine. Example, typical example, aniline. So if you look by resonance, these electrons are shifted here and these electrons are shifted, the benzene ring. That means NH2 group, since it is having lone pairs of electrons, it is electron releasing group. So it will release electrons to the benzene ring. But when you consider alkyl amine and RNH2, here, though NH2 group is releasing group, here R group is electron releasing group. Here R group is electron releasing group. So here what happens, the lone pairs of electrons become more denser on nitrogen and here they become less denser. Now basicity means what? Where nitrogen of amines can give its a lone pair easily. So where it can give lone pairs easily, here it is contributing the lone pairs in resonance. And here this alkyl group itself is again giving because it is an electron releasing group, right? Plus I effect. So here electron density is more on nitrogen. So nitrogen can give its lone pairs very easily. Yes. Therefore, this becomes alkyl amines become more basic, whereas aryl amines become less basic. So alkyl amines become more basic and aryl amines become less basic. So which is the correct option? Aryl amines are generally less basic than alkyl amines because nitrogen lone pair electrons are delocalized by interaction with aromatic ring pi electron system. This is the correct option. So in case of aryl amines, there comes the question of resonance, whereas in case of alkyl amines, there comes the question of positive inductive effect. In case of aryl amines, though not only resonance, there comes the question of negative inductive effect also. Okay. Then which one of the following nitro compounds do not react with nitrous acid? Which of the following compounds do not react with nitrous acid? So they have given all the nitro compounds. Which one will not react with nitrous acid? If you look in the first case, the NO2 group is attached to CH2, which in turn is attached to CH2. So here there is a possibility reaction with nitrous acid, HNO2, is highly unstable. Yes, it is highly unstable. So here, where NO2 group is freely available, that will be reacting. So in case of option A, it is primary. In case of option B also, it is primary, but here it is attached to this propyl group. Whereas in case of C, it is tertiary carbon. Case of here, it is not possible because of steric hindrance. And here also, it is not possible because this itself is electron withdrawing group. So basically, we can expect it in option B. Like how to explain this is, where to express, okay, here NO2 group is attached to primary carbon. Okay, we cannot expect it here. Here also it is attached to primary carbon. Here it is attached to secondary carbon. Here it is attached to tertiary. Yes, so we can expect it in tertiary only. The reason is, if you see in a tertiary carbon, there is no hydrogen here. Whereas here there are two hydrogens, here there are two hydrogens, here there are two hydrogens. So no acidic hydrogen is present on this carbon having NO2 group. Therefore, it will not react with nitrous acid. So it will not react with nitrous acid. Okay. A given nitrogen containing aromatic compound A reacts with stin and HCl followed by HNO2 to give an unstable compound B. B on treatment with phenol forms a beautiful colored compound. Directly we know the compound now. See, a nitrogen containing compound is there. It reacts with the stannous chloride and HCl. Yes. So, and forms followed by HNO2. So first it is reacting with stannous chloride and HCl. Then it is reacting with HNO2, forms an unstable compound. And we know that unstable compound, it is diazonium salt. Yes. And then when treatment with phenol, it is forming a beautifully colored compound. So obviously it is forming a dye. So what is the compound here? Here the compound is aniline, because aniline on treatment with nitrous acid forms benzene diazonium salt. And if you want aniline, and the reagent given is stannous chloride, so it is nothing but nitro compound, nitrobenzene. So nitrobenzene with tin and HCl forms aniline. Aniline with nitrous acid forms benzene diazonium chloride. This with phenol, it forms coupling reaction, N, double bond N. Here we have para position attack. And this is a orange colored compound. It is nothing but para hydroxy azobenzene. Para hydroxy azobenzene, yes. So let us check out C12H10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So C12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, C12, H10, N, 2, and O. Yes, it is not this, like this, N, 2, and O. Correct? So it forms this compound. And what is the compound? Starting compound, it is nitrobenzene. So nitrobenzene, when it undergoes reduction, it will form aniline. Okay, next question. Identify product A and predict the type of reaction. So methoxy group is there, OCH3, and there is Br. So bromoanisole, the compound is, sorry, metabromoanisole. Yes, this is a compound. They are treating it with NaNH2. NaNH2 is nothing but it is sodamide. Yes. It is a dehydrohalogenating agent. What it is? It is a very strong dehydrohalogenating agent. Yes. Halogen is eliminated from beta position. Hydrogen is eliminated from beta position. So here, HBr gets eliminated. Yes. So what do we get? So hydrogen has to go out. So here what is created? Positive charge will be created. So we get compound like this. OCH3, positive charge. Br also goes out. When Br also goes out, this is benzene ring, right? When Br also goes out, so this positive charge is created. The Br goes out and here double bond is created. Here positive charge and here there is a double bond. Then what happens? NaNH2, NaNH2 is taken in ammonia, remember. It is taken in ammonia. So it will react with ammonia and forms NH2. NH3 contains a nucleophile, NH2. That will attack where? It will take out these electrons and it will attack here. So what do we get? We get NH2 here. So it is meta-amino anisole. Example of a substitution reaction. It is an example of substitution reaction. So meta amino, yes. This is the product. This is the product, yes. So we should be knowing what happens with the compound. Okay. So NH3 is meta directing group. And hence besides para 51%, ortho 2% and meta product is 47% is also formed. Okay. Nitration of aniline in strong acidic medium also gives M-nitroaniline because NH3 group is what? Meta-directing group. Hence, if you take in case of the acidic medium, what will happen? In acidic medium, NH2 gets converted to NH3 plus ion. I'll just show you. Why do we get, usually we have seen this reaction, right? When you carry out a nitration of aniline, NH2, nitration of aniline, HNO3 and H2SO4 in the strong medium, we get meta, ortho, meta and para product. So NO2 here plus we get meta product, NH2, NO2 and also we get para product. This is the typical reaction of aniline. We get all these three products. Para is 51%, meta is 47%, and ortho is just 2%. So meta product is obtained. Why? Because we expect only ortho and para, right? But why meta product is obtained is aniline, since you are taking a strong acidic medium, there is equilibrium reaction in presence of strong acidic medium. Here, NH2 will abstract hydrogen and forms NH3 plus ion. This NH3 plus ion is meta directing group. sometimes. Yes, it abstracts the proton. And this NH3 anilinium ion, this is called anilinium ion. It is meta-directing group, and therefore meta product is also formed with a significant yield. That's the reason. So the in strong acidic medium, aniline is present as anilinium ion. It is present as anilinium ion. That's the reason what is formed. Meta-directing product is also formed. Correct? We get meta-directing product. Okay. Then, moving to the next question. Next question, which of the following is a carbohydrate? Yes, leucine, albumin, maltase, insulin. Leucine is an amino acid, albumin is a protein, maltase is an enzyme. So insulin, insulin is the carbohydrate with inulin. I'm sorry, inulin is the carbohydrate which is stored in the roots of dahlia. It is stored in the roots of dahlia. So correct option is option C. Next. So inulin, it is stored in the roots of dahlia. Next question. General formula of carbohydrates is, we have discussed in the synopsis itself, what is the general formula of carbohydrates? Carbohydrates are nothing but hydrates of carbon dioxide, hydrates of carbon. Yes. So their general formula is CxH2OY times. So it is option C, which is the correct option. Yes. Next question. When sucrose is heated with concentrated nitric acid, the product is, when sucrose is heated with concentrated nitric acid. So you have sucrose, C12H22O11, you are heating it with concentrated nitric acid. So heating it. The product formed is oxalic acid. You get oxalic acid. This is the product formed. So the product formed is oxalic acid. Sucrose, there are various reactions. When you treat it with certain enzyme, you get different product. But here the question is, when it is heated with nitric acid, we get oxalic acid. Next question. Optical activity is shown by. Yes, optical activity. See, we know the definition of carbohydrates. What does the definition of carbohydrates say? Carbohydrates are optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones, or which give these compounds upon hydrolysis. Yes. So optically, all carbohydrates are optically active. So whether it is monosaccharides, monosugars, or oligosaccharides or polysaccharides, all are optically active. So here glucose, fructose are monosaccharides. Sucrose is a disaccharide. So all of them are optically active. So correct option is option D. Next question. The disaccharide present in milk is what? It is lactose. It is lactose. Yes. What is lactose? It is a combination of two monosaccharides, that is glucose and galactose. Glucose and galactose. Next question. The charring of sugar when treated with concentrated sulfuric acid is due to. Yes, the charring of sugar. Sugar becomes black, right? When treated with concentrated sulfuric acid. It is because of concentrated sulfuric acid is a dehydrating agent. So what type of reaction occurs here? Dehydration occurs. Water is removed in this reaction. When sugar is treated with concentrated acid, water is removed from the sugar and therefore it becomes charred, and that is called dehydration. Option C is the correct option. Yes. Which among the following is the simplest sugar? Monosaccharides are the simplest sugars. Monosaccharides, they cannot be further hydrolyzed because they contain only one sugar unit, and they are the simplest sugars. So which is monosaccharide here? Glucose is monosaccharide. It is the simplest sugar. Rest all, cellulose, starch, and glycogen are what? They are polysaccharides. In fructose, the possible optical isomers are. Yes, fructose, whenever you are trying to find optical isomers, the formula is 2 raised to n. Yes, the formula is 2 raised to n, where n is number of chiral carbons. How many chiral carbons are there? Those many isomers, that will be number n, and 2 raised to n, you'll get that many optical isomers. Fructose has got how many chiral carbons? Fructose, glucose, and galactose, they have got 3 chiral carbons. Yes, so n is equal to 3. So 2 raised to 3, 2 twos are 4, 4 twos are 8. So how many optical isomers are possible? 8 optical isomers are possible. What is the basic formula for starch? Yes, C6H10O5N. This is the basic formula of starch. And starch on reduction gives what? It gives us glucose, because starch is made up of large number of glucose units. Which of the following compounds is abundantly found in nature? During the synopsis only we have discussed this. It is cellulose. Cellulose is most abundantly found in nature. It is the main constituent of all the plant cells. All the plant cells. So major abundance is cellulose itself. The proteins which are soluble in water. We have two types of proteins. Fibrous proteins and globular proteins. So which are soluble in water? Yes. Fibrous proteins are insoluble. Okay, the question is which are insoluble in water. You can take the example for fibrous proteins. Can you tell group the examples? Fibrous proteins. As the name suggests, they have fiber-like structures. They have structures like this. Proteins are nothing but polypeptides. So they have amine groups, amide peptides. Yes. So what happens? Polypeptides means it is nothing but RCH, NH2, C double bond O, then NH, then CH, COOH, then R. It is something like this. Yes, I've shown you just an example of a dipeptide. Proteins are polypeptides. Such poly, n number of amino groups will be chained together. So what happens in when fibrous proteins are there? This R group is, since they are present in hair-like structures, R group is suspended outside. R group is nothing but alkyl group. And we know that alkyl groups are hydrophobic. They are water repelling. Yes, so they are suspended outside. Since they are suspended outside, when you put fibrous proteins in water, hydrophobic part will repel water. It will repel water and it will remain insoluble. That only when you see globular proteins. Globular proteins are also made up of same polypeptide chains, right? But in globular proteins, these polypeptide chains involve coiling, bending and coiling. So when coiling is taking place, the R group is directed inwards. The R group is directed inwards. So when R group goes inside, CONH, C double bond O, COH, NH2, these groups come outside. They are what? Polar groups. And polar groups are what? Hydrophobic, hydrophilic. So since they are hydrophilic, they will dissolve in water. They attract water and remain soluble in water. Examples also you can see fibrous proteins. The proteins present in skin, nails, hair. Yes, keratin. The protein is keratin. These are insoluble in water. Whereas globular protein, hemoglobin, albumin, egg albumin. Yes, insulin. So these are all globular proteins which are soluble in water. Yes. So the proteins which are insoluble in water are fibrous proteins. And I just told you why they are insoluble in water also. Because of their structural arrangement. They remain insoluble. Yes. Next question. The proteins with a prosthetic group are called. So proteins with a prosthetic group. What they are called? The proteins with the prosthetic group. Pseudoproteins, complex proteins, conjugated proteins, or polypeptides. See, remember this. If you have a simple protein plus prosthetic group. Prosthetic group is nothing but non-protein part. Non-protein part is prosthetic group. You can call it as prosthetic group. Or you can sometimes call it as cofactor also. Yes, you can call it as cofactor. So a simple protein plus non-protein, that is prosthetic group, becomes conjugated protein. Becomes conjugated protein. Yes, so option C is correct. Proteins are hydrolyzed by enzymes into. Proteins, when they are hydrolyzed by enzymes, what do we get? We get amino acids, because proteins contain amino acids. They are the chain of amino acids, right? N number of amino acids, so when they are clubbed together, combined together, they form proteins. So they give amino acids. Okay, proteins when heated with concentrated nitric acid give yellow color. This is, see, protein plus concentrated nitric acid gives us yellow color. This test is given by proteins which contain alpha amino acids containing benzene ring, such as tyrosine, phenylalanine, etc. The yellow color is due to nitration of the benzene ring. When there occurs nitration of the benzene ring, therefore there will be yellow color obtained. So this nitration is nothing but oxidizing test. This test is called as xanthoprotic test. What it is called as? Xanthoprotic test. Starch is converted into maltose by. So starch is converted into maltose by which enzyme? It is converted into maltose by diastase enzyme. So option D is the correct option. We have seen different enzymes and conversion factors also we have seen. Enzyme which combines with non-protein part to form a functional enzyme is. The enzyme which combines with the non-protein part to form a functional enzyme, it is called apoenzyme. It is called apoenzyme. Please do remember, this is the definition. Enzyme which combines with the non-protein part to form a functional enzyme, that is called apoenzymes. Yes. Holoenzymes are there. So combination of enzyme plus coenzyme, that is non-protein factor required for functioning of the enzyme. So those are holoenzymes. Apoenzymes means what? They combine with non-protein factor to form the functional enzymes. Incorrect statement is. So which is the incorrect statement? All proteins are enzymes. All enzymes are biocatalysts. Enzymes are thermoliable. All enzymes are proteins. Yes. So which is the correct answer? Yes, the correct answer. Which is the wrong answer? Enzymes are biocatalysts. Yes, they catalyze the biochemical reactions. Enzymes are thermolabile. Yes, they are active only under optimum temperature. Enzymes are proteins, obviously. But proteins are not enzymes. See, there are enzymes. There are proteins out of which some are enzymes. But all proteins are not enzymes. All enzymes are proteins. But all proteins are not enzymes. Yes. So option A is the incorrect statement. A non-protein organic part attached firmly by a covalent linkage to an apoenzyme is called. A non-protein organic part attached to firmly by a covalent linkage to an apoenzyme, it is called a coenzyme. What it is called? It is called a coenzyme. To an apoenzyme, which part is attached? That is coenzyme. Yes, option C is the right option. Vegetable oils like wheat germ oil, sunflower oil, etc. are good sources of. Oils are sources of vitamin E. So only it is called tocopherol. So vitamin E is mainly present in vegetable oils like wheat germ oil, sunflower oil, etc. So vitamin E is the correct option. It is a fat soluble vitamin. Vitamin B1, what it is called? It is called riboflavin. Vitamin B2, thiamine. Vitamin B6, pyridoxine. Vitamin B12, cobalamine. Yes, cyanocobalamine. We should be knowing the names of all the vitamins. So vitamin B1. Yes, vitamin B1 is called thiamine. Vitamin B1 is called thiamine. Option C is the right option. Which of the following statement vitamins is water soluble? We know that only vitamin B complexes and vitamin C are water soluble. Vitamin A, D, K, E are fat soluble. So vitamin E, vitamin D are fat soluble. What is retinol? Retinol is vitamin A. So that is also for fat soluble. What is riboflavin? Riboflavin is vitamin B2. So it is the water soluble vitamin. All other vitamins, vitamin E, what is the name? Tocopherol. Vitamin K, what is the name? Phylloquinone. Vitamin A, retinol. They are all what? They are fat soluble vitamins. Fat soluble vitamins. Which of the following is not produced by the human body? Which of the following is not produced by the human body? Enzymes, they are produced. Proteins, yes, they are produced. Nucleic acids, yes, they are present. DNA and RNA. Vitamins, most of the vitamins cannot be synthesized or produced in the human body. And therefore, they are supplied through the diet. Only vitamin D can be synthesized in the body by the help of sunlight. Please do remember. Only vitamin D, by the sunlight, we can synthesize vitamin D. Rest all have to be provided by the external diet. Which is a fat soluble vitamin? It is vitamin A. Retinol is fat soluble vitamin, whereas rest all are water soluble vitamins. Hydrogen bonds between cytosine and guanine. What is this? This is nothing but the sugars present in the DNA. Yes. it is AT and it is CG, adenine, guanine, thymine and cytosine. Yes, so between cytosine and guanine, there are three hydrogen bonds present. Between adenine and thymine, there are two hydrogen. This is not double or triple bond. These are what? They are hydrogen bonds. The compounds get stabilized here by hydrogen bonds. Between A and T, these both are called as complementary base pairs. They are called as complementary base pairs. Base pairs. Yes, present in DNA. Adenine, thymine, the two hydrogen bonds, cytosine and guanine, three hydrogen bonds. So option three is the right option. The carbon atoms of pentose sugar involved in phosphodiester bond formation in DNA and RNA are. The carbon atoms of pentose sugar involved in phosphodiester bond formation in DNA and RNA are C3 prime and C5 prime. If you look at the structure, you'll understand this. It is C3 prime and C5 prime. That to which structure I'm talking about? I'm talking about the Watson and Crick model, that is alpha helical structure of DNA as well as RNA. DNA is a double-stranded structure, RNA is a single-stranded structure. The successive nucleotides of DNA are covalently linked by, they are linked, what are nucleotides? They are nothing but nucleosides plus phosphor linkage, yes? So they are linked by how? They are linked by phosphodiester bonds. So it is option D. Peptide bonds are present in proteins. Glycosidic bonds are present in carbohydrates. Hydrogen bonds, they are stabilizing bonds. Yes. Phosphodiester linkages, they are found in DNA nucleotides. Next, the intermediate compound found in the conversion of starch to glucose. Starch to glucose. The intermediate compound formed is. Starch is first converted to maltose using maltase enzyme. Diastase enzyme. Maltose is then converted to glucose. So, which is the intermediate compound formed? Yes, it is maltose. Next, oxidation of glucose. The question says, is one of the most important reaction in oxidation of glucose is one of the most important reactions in living cell. What is the number of ATP molecules? What is the number of ATP molecules generated in the cells from one molecule of glucose? So what is the number of ATP molecules generated from one molecule of glucose? Yes. So here you can see oxidation of glucose. So C6H12O6 plus oxygen. Oxidation occurs, you get CO2 plus H2O plus ATP. Yes, here, how many molecules of oxygen required are 6. So if you balance this reaction, you will get to know here it is 6 carbon dioxide because 6 C6. Then we have 6 H2O because H12, 6 2s are 12. So total how many? It is 38 ATP molecules are generated. So option A is the correct option. So 38 ATP molecules are generated. Amino acid with a symmetrical carbon atom is, the only amino acid which is optically inactive is glycine. Yes, optically active amino acid is glycine. Only this is optically active because it contains chiral carbon. Next question, the species which can best serve as initiators for cationic polymerization. Yes, for cationic polymerization, we need electron deficient species. And if you look here, AlCl3 is electron deficient. By how you can say, it is a Lewis acid. So electron pair acceptor it is. So it can be used to generate a cation. When it accepts the electron from a compound, it will form a cation, positively charged ion. Yes. So AlCl3 helps in cationic polymerization. Which of the following statements is correct? All amino acids except lysine are optically active, wrong. All amino acids are optically active, wrong. All amino acids except glycine are optically active. Okay, glycine is the only amino acid which is optically inactive, students. Conclusion here, this wrong concept I had told. Glycine, just glycine. This is the only amino acid which is optically inactive because it is having two hydrogens attached to carbon. Rest all are optically active. So all amino acids except glycine are optically active. Except glycine, all are optically active. Okay. Which of the following compounds can be detected by Molish test? What is Molish test? This is the general test for carbohydrates. What we do here is, 1 or 2 drops of alcoholic solution of alpha naphthol is added to 2 ml glucose solution. And some amount of H2SO4, say 1 ml of H2SO4 solution is added carefully along the sides of test tube. What happens, there is formation of a ring, violet ring at the junction of two liquids. If there is formation of a ring, violet ring at the junction of two liquids, it confirms the presence of carbohydrates. So this is the test for sugars. It is the test for sugars. Aspirin is known as, to give the name for aspirin, you should be knowing the structure of aspirin. Aspirin is nothing but benzene ring. Here it is OCOCH3 and here it is COOH. So what is this? It is nothing but acetyl salicylic acid. Acetyl salicylic acid is called aspirin. Yes, it is used as antipyretic. It is used as an antipyretic. So aspirin. Okay, acetyl salicylic acid. Synthesis of each molecule of glucose involves photosynthesis. Again, so we have a synthesis of glucose means, I'll write the general reaction only. Yes, here we use 12 NADPH plus 18 ATP. It gives C6H12O6 plus 12 NADPH plus 18 ADP. Yes, so we get this. So here NADPH is what? It is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate, NADPH. Sometimes it is written like this also, NADP plus. So H comes out. So it is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. ATP, we know, adenosine triphosphate. ADP is adenosine diphosphate. Yes. So these are the abbreviated this. So when synthesis of glucose in photosynthesis is involved, so what happens? 6 oxygen molecules, 12 NADPH molecules, 18 ATP will give glucose, 1 molecule of glucose. So here the question asked is, how much molecules it involves? So it involves how many? 18 ATP molecules. It involves 18 ATP molecules. So which of the following bases is not present in DNA? I just told you complementary base pairs. A, T and C, 3 hydrogen bonds, G. So adenine, thymine, cytosine and guanine are present. Quinoline is not present in bases. It is not present in bases. In RNA, it is A, T, C, U. Uracil is present. Whereas in DNA, it is A, T, C, G. Yes. Next, which one of the following is condensation polymer? Yes, this is a question from polymer. Let me tell you here also, it is Teflon. Teflon is an example for condensation polymer. Last all are addition polymers. Which of the following compounds is not an antacid? Antacids are what? They are, they reduce the acidity. So here you can see cimetidine is antacid. Ranitidine is antacid. Aluminium hydroxide is also antacid. But phenylazine is not antacid. It is an antidepressant. It is an antidepressant. It is given as tranquilizer. Yes. Which of the following is water soluble vitamin? It is vitamin C is water soluble. So vitamin C is water soluble. Next question. Which polymer is used in the manufacture of paints and lacquers? Paints and lacquers, we should be knowing the, see this one question is involved here in this topic. It is what? It is glyptal. It is used in the manufacture of paints and lacquers. Yes, paints and lacquers. Polypropene, we use it in pipes, polyvinyl chloride pipes, speculite, it is used, various uses are there. Which of the following statements about low density polythene is false? Low density polythene is chemically inert and it is tough, but flexible and a poor conductor of electricity. Hence, it is used in the insulation of electricity carrying wires and manufacture of squeeze bottles, toys and flexible pipes. Remember. So what is the wrong statement here? It is a poor conductor of electricity. Yes, it is synthesis requires a dioxygen or a peroxide initiate as a catalyst. Yes, it is used in manufacture of buckets and dustbins. No, low density polythene is used in the manufacture of squeeze bot toys, flexible pipes and all. Its synthesis requires high pressure. That is correct. So option C is the wrong statement. Next question, which of the following is an anionic detergent? It is option B. We'll discuss this again. It is option A, I'm sorry. So A is an anionic detergent, sodium lauryl sulfate. B is a cationic detergent. Rest all are just salts. Yes. Thiol group is present in. Where is thiol group present? Yes. So thiol, this is an example of amino acids. So cysteine is an amino acid having thiol group. Thiol group, I can show you. Yes, CH2CH. This is NH2COOH. And here we have, yes, H. This is thiol group. So cysteine has got thiol group. It is an amino acid having thiol group. The formation of which of the polymers involves hydrolysis reaction? Hydrolysis. It is option B. See here, I'll just show you. Nylon 6 is prepared from a monomer caprolactam. The caprolactam structure is this is caprolactam. One bond, two bonds, three, four, five, and six. And here there is one bond. This on hydrolysis, acid hydrolysis, it gives such N molecules. If you take such N caprolactam molecules, we get CH2 five times. And then N molecules of OH, then C double bond O, CH2 five times, and then NH2. So there are six carbon atoms, 5 plus 1. So this compound is called nylon 6. The number 6 involves the number of carbon atoms. This will undergo polymerization. That means many such molecules, they will undergo polymerization to give C double bond O, CH2 five times, and then NH. This continues up to N molecules. So this will be nylon 6. Elimination of water involves. Yes. So this is nylon 6. It is on hydrolysis. It gives this compound. Moving to the next question. Which of the following will behave reducing sugar in aqueous KOH solution? So reducing sugar. Reducing sugar. You can see there. We know that all monosaccharides are reducing sugars. All disaccharides except sugars, sucrose is a reducing sugar. So here, which one will behave as a reducing sugar, which will have open CHO or ketonic group and react with mild oxidizing agents? So it is option B. I'll show you how. I'll just show you how. So here, if you take this compound, yes, here there is OH, OH over here, and then here OCOCH3, CH2OH, and here I have CH2OH, correct? So when you treat it with aqueous KOH, there is elimination of CH3COOK comes out. So what do we get here is, O, CH2OH remains as it is. Here OH remains as it is. And here also OH remains as it is. OCH3 comes out, so CH2OH. And here it becomes OH, correct? This is in equilibrium with OH, there is CH2OH. Then we have this here. There is OH already present. And then here we have OH. This part, double bond O, comes out like this. OH. So here ketonic group has come out, so it will act as a reducing sugar. So remember this structure. So because of this, this acts as a reducing sugar. It acts as a reducing sugar. You can note it down. So these are some of the questions on biomolecules, what we have discussed today. In the next slide, we'll be taking up the next topic of organic chemistry. So hope amines and biomolecules, the synopsis, as well as the multiple choice questions are clear to you all. Thank you.